The demonstrations that later turned into riots in the capital Nairobi led to loss of lives and many property was destroyed. Among the property that was set on fire is Uganda House located at Kenyatta Avenue, which houses Uganda's consular office in Nairobi, Kenya. Today, the Minister of Foreign Affairs in charge of Regional Affairs, John Mulimba, condemned the acts of violence that led to loss of lives and property. Mulimba said Uganda House, which had just been renovated, was due for opening this Friday. Following yesterday's incident, he says the government is taking stock of what was destroyed.
The demonstration, which began peacefully, later on turned violent, and property was destroyed across the country, Republic of Kenya. A number of properties were destroyed, but most notably, and to us, the Uganda House on Kenyatta Avenue, which was newly rehabilitated, was both destroyed and torched.
Mulimba also assured Ugandans living in Kenya that the government of Kenya has regained control and they should not be worried about security.
But we'd like to regret and we'd like to call on all East Africans, especially our brothers and sisters in Kenya, to remain calm and demonstrate peacefully. To Ugandans who are in Kenya, this morning I've spoken to the Minister of Foreign Affairs of Kenya and also the Minister of Interior, who have assured us that the government of Kenya is doing everything possible to restore calm, and very soon normal business will continue.
Yesterday, Kenyan nationals held demonstrations to protest the government's move to raise taxes through the new finance bill. The move was meant to introduce taxes or fees on a range of daily items and services, including internet data, fuel, bank transfers, and diapers. The proposals are part of the Kenyan government's efforts to raise an extra $2.7 billion in domestic revenue. Protesters, who see this as a punitive measure, since the cost of living is already high, rioted across various cities in the country, resulting in loss of lives and property. Youth belonging to the National Unit Platform were dispersed and some were arrested for holding an illegal assembly in the premises of Musisi Hussein, also known as Kalaso Kokoriroko, in Nanziga, Nsanji Town Castle, most of them believed to be border operators based at Maya Stage. After making processions in Maya Town, they assembled in Kalaso's residence, where they held a press conference to voice their condemnation of what they called increased corruption by legislators in Parliament. During the presser, they also condemned Busiro East Member of Parliament, Medard Segwena, for his involvement in the Thanksgiving ceremony organized by the Parliament member representing Nyendo Mukungwe, Mathias Mpuga. In a panicky mode, Kalaso proclaimed himself as a Member of Parliament for Busiro East to replace the elected Member of Parliament, Medard Segwena. Shortly, police swung into action and made some arrests, prompting other youth to run, leaving behind their motorcycles, which police impounded. Kalaso had locked himself in the house and was called by the DPC to come out, after which he was arrested as well. The impounded motorcycles and people arrested were taken to Nsanji police station for questioning. Police in Butaleja district, on orders of the Assistant Resident District Commissioner Jimmy Nambiro, have today arrested George Odeng, the headmaster, and two teachers of Nampologoma Primary School in Nabiganda Town Council, for allegedly dismissing students for failing to pay school fees. It is reported that the assistant RDC was tipped off by one of the parents whose children had been sent away from school for not paying 10,000 shillings meant for development fee of the school.
Management ya somero ya gamba ya tula leyi santo mwana mburi mwana aino kutola omtu wazi
ama somero amalala na gutu. Of course tulina history me sente ze bachaji ngeza abane za. Do you know that our headmaster zao basa suziza abane sente ze okwe wandisa mubibuzi ngate government ya sasu le sente za registration.
The arrested, including the head teacher George Odeng and his two teachers, were taken to Nampologoma police post where they recorded statements. The accused persons were later granted police bond following a closed-door meeting between the Butaleja district team and the resident district commissioner Hajira Namagogwe. The Assistant RDC for Utalija, Jimmy Nambiro, said that charging illegal fees in UPE schools is an act of sabotage to government programs and should not be tolerated, warning school managers against the vice.
For any reason, tebalina kubanga bagoba mwana kuva musomero alemege na maso na kusoma. Omwana mba mukanyiza special nga bazade bato ne bakanya ati alina okulya musomero. Mwabata lese sente mumume bumye mmere.
Nampologoma Primary School is a government-aided school under UPE with an estimated enrollment of 3,000 learners.
Download the app on App Store or Google Play Store now. Vision Digital Experience, the future of media.